Hi guys, it's Bright and welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be something a little bit different and something brand new for my channel. We're going to be doing a texture pack review and I think I'm going to be starting a new series like this. So we're going to be trying out different texture packs. The texture pack I have on today is the Betrina texture pack. I'm not too sure if I'm saying that 100% right. But it'll be in the description if you guys want to go check it out. This texture pack is known to be cute and it's basically for the Pixelmon mod. So there's a few things that have been animated for that. But other than that, the blocks are still cute and adorable and really aesthetic for building. So behind me is the basic layout for a texture pack review. And then over to my right, we have all of the basic blocks that should have been changed and have been changed. So let's get started. As you can tell, there has been quite a few things that have had a upgrade. There has been the doors, the quartz, all the wool, all the wood, basically everything that you need to build. So knowing that it's for 1.15, not all the blocks will be retextured, but all of the stuff that has been before 1.16, I expect them to be retextured. So the three things I'm looking for in a good texture pack, in a texture pack that is known to be finished, is the completion of the texture pack. Is everything retextured that should be retextured? And how is textures in them and how does it look overall? How well can you tell the blocks apart from the original one? So because most people have played with the base game texture pack all before, how close are they to the original blocks and will you be able to tell them from them so you're not having to go back into your inventory to tell what they are? And number three, overall, how well does it look and how well does it stay for the name that you type in when you go into searching for the texture pack? What I searched is Q Visco Girl Texture Pack. So how well does it revolve a cute Visco Girl? So just by standing here with knowing that it's 1.16, you can tell most blocks have been updated. There's a few that haven't though. The few blocks that you can tell is the redstone, basically all redstone stuff. But if it's for a cute Visco Girl texture pack, you know that they shouldn't be updated at all. You shouldn't, if you're a Visco Girl in this, most of the time they don't play with redstone. So I'm not too worried about it. Would it have been nice? Yes. Is it finished though? I'm gonna say right now, it's looking pretty good. So what you can tell from the water and the lava, they both did get a retexture and this water is looking so nice. It looks so much better than the base game and it really looks like there is waves when it comes down in a flow like this, which I really, really like. The lava also did get a retexturize too and I think this looks beautiful. It's looking like scaly and something that you really wouldn't want to mess with. So we're going to move over here now that we've seen mostly all of the blocks over there. But here are all of the basic animals that you're going to find in Minecraft. This is a pig. It's not pink, but I think it's supposed to be dirty from playing in the mud. And I think that is adorable. Here are the horses. They changed a whole bunch with them and they kind of look like horses now. I really like it. And they even come with a mane. So that's really pretty. The mushrooms, the only thing that got a retexture on them are the mushrooms. So did they finish the mushroom? No, but they did kind of retexture it and it's looking like it's getting there. And here's what the cows look like. They're, I don't even know how to describe that color, but they got cute kawaii cheeks and they're adorable. Here are the chickens. You can tell that the eggs have been retextured too, but the chickens are now brown and they also have the kawaii cheeks. And oh my gosh. These chickens, I'm telling you, those eyes, they're killer for some love. this is what the bounties look like. They're like a nice white to black ombre, and they're also super, super cute. And then we have the sheep. I don't know what really happened to them, why they burned face, but I mean, you can tell them, you can tell that they're sheep. I wouldn't necessarily say that they're the cutest thing in the world, but, you know, you can tell that it's a sheep. Now we're going to move on to the actual blocks. Now that we have all of the main things done, I put it into a peaceful world, so I can't really do any of the mobs, but that's okay. You guys can figure those ones out for yourself when you download the texture pack. So here is all of the wood blocks, and in the order that they go in is oak, spruce, birch, jungle, acacia, and dark oak. And these are the new nether stuff, so we can just cancel this stuff out. But you have your wood, your stripped wood, which came in, I think it came in one point, I think it came out now, so there's not gonna be any retextures with it. But you have your stairs, your planks, and these have been updated, so you have all of your trapdoors are brand new and ready to be built with. I think most people use them as windows, but you know, you can do them with whatever you want because they're retextured, so they're super cute. These are the fences, so we have, I don't know what happened and why the dark oak turns blue, but I think that's for building purposes, and they match their fence to their gate really well. So these are the gates. Super cute. Then we have the pressure plates. These are the doors, and they look super updated, and oh my gosh, I really want to build with them. Moving along here, we have the sand. So this is actually the red sand, and they turned it pink, and it's super cute as well. And then they have the regular sand, which I think the textures for it looks super nice. Moving on down, we have our stone, granite, andesite, and diorite, I believe is the way that they're put there. And this is the new stone, smooth stone that came out in 1.13. So that did get an update. This is the smooth stone slabs, just so we know what they look like in a pile, so they don't turn into the blocks. They stay as slabs. And then you have all of your building stones. So you have your cobblestone, your mossy cobble, your stone brick, your mossy stone brick, your corrupted stone brick, and then I think these are the pillars. They don't look like pillars no more, but yeah. These are all of your ores. So you got gold, iron, coal, lapis, redstone, diamonds, and emeralds. And oh my gosh, I can't wait to find these underground. Moving along, we have all of the wool. And let me tell you, this wool texture is so beautiful. Like, when you build with the regular wool, you're just like, I don't want to build with that. But this stuff is so nice. It's, I don't know how to describe it. It's just super, super nice. Then we have all of the glass. So all the glass got a new texture. And guys, there's basically almost a clear one here. This one is the purple one. And then this one is the dark gray. So all of it, except for these two for some reason, didn't get a retexture. Don't know what happened there. But yeah. And the regular glass. And the red glass. I guess they didn't want to retexture those, but the glass and the glass panes are on top. This right here is the terracotta. So we have in the same order as last time. It to me doesn't really look like terracotta, but this is meant for a building type of block in this texture pack. So, I mean, that makes sense, right? Look at the regular terracotta. Beautiful. This is the concrete, so it has almost the same texture as the terracotta. It's just in a smaller version of it, and it still looks super nice. And then this, of course, is the concrete powder, which got a brand new sandy looking texture to it. And all of this right here is the miscellaneous blocks that we all use. Bedrock, and then gravel, obsidian, I believe is what this is. And then you've got your bookcases, your pumpkins, your watermelon. These are your hay blocks. And then you have your crafting table, your chests, your furnace, which is beautiful. The crafting table didn't really get a free texture, but the book did, so I don't know what happened there. But moving over here, we have all of our end city stuff and end stuff. So we have all of the end blocks, except for the portal was not changed, but I don't expect it to be. And then we have the end city blocks, the purple blocks, and the head as well of the dragon is changed with the... I don't know, this crystal just blows up is what I know. And then we have the fruits. And then the thing that's making the most noise right now is the nether. So this is all of the nether ore. Soul sands, the quartz, oh my gosh, my brain. And then this is what the portal looks like when you have it built. These are all of the fences that go with these blocks over here. So this is... new texture, but it looks more pixely than the other stuff, but that's fine. Still looks super nice. And these torches also came with the new snapshot. So right here is what the sea temple stuff looks like, including the walls and the wet and dry sponges and your snow blocks. This did not get a retexture because it new. I'm not too sure how new, but I know that it's new. So if it's not retextured, I'm not sure what version it came out in, but I don't blame it to not be retextured. Everything else did, and it's nice. Your sea stuff has been retextured, like your coral blocks, except for the kelp, but these all got a little bit of retexture. They got a newly, instead of it being a 32 block, it's a 64, so it's a little bit more detailed. We don't have to worry about any of this stuff because it's in the new snapshot, but I just wanted to see what the blocks looked like. So this is for me. This is the mushroom stuff. So this is the stem, the pink, and the white, the red mushroom, I guess is what it would have been. And this is like the brown one. So yeah, that's what the mushroom stuff looks like. And this is your glow blocks. This is also in the new snapshot, but this is the glowstone, and this is, I'm gonna say the torches, which they now look like the new lamps. Super cute. Finally, we have our minecarts, and the minecarts got a really big upgrade, and I'm loving them. You have your power rails, and then, your redstone lit power rails, your iron doors and stuff, but they never got retextured, so, yeah. So we did a quick run through of the texture pack, and let me tell you, I'm going to give it a 9 for completion of the texture pack. There's a few things that I would have retextured in it, like everything would have got a new texture, but obviously that takes a really long time, and if you wanted to get this texture pack out, you might have rushed it a little bit, but I'm going to give it a 9 overall and for a score of completion, and I think that is pretty good. And how well you can tell the blocks apart, obviously a few of them are going to be difficult because it's new textures and you want to make sure that you can be able to build with them, so I'm also going to give that a 9. I would have changed the terracotta so that I would have at least known what it was. I didn't exactly know what it was when I was looking through it, so I'm gonna give it a 9, but that's the only block that I didn't know what it was. And for an overall look, I'm gonna give it a 10. I think it's super cute. It's definitely visco and cute, so I'm gonna give it a 10. I really like this, and I think I might start using it for myself. I'm in the snapshot right now, as you can tell from a few of the blocks, but yeah, so that's really nice. As an overall score of this texture pack, I'm gonna give it a 9.5. So this texture pack is almost fully done and done enough that you can use it in your game and have almost all of your blocks retextured. So I'm gonna say if you wanna go get it, you should go to the link in the description box. It's there ready for you to download. And if you're playing the Pixelmon mod, be sure to use this one because this one is what it's for. But if you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Comment down below what you think of the texture pack. Subscribe to become a part of the Lightning Squad. If you're feeling it, you can go and check out my description. It has my Discord link in it, so you can come and chat with me if you're feeling like it. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!